Hi, this is Shoptalk, and I'm Ria Tanwatko Trillo. The versatility of crepes, which can be served as a meal or dessert, has made the crepe business appealing to entrepreneurs. But as with other food concepts, there's more to this kind of enterprise than just putting ingredients together to serve a good-tasting crepe. Today, we'll talk to foodpreneurs in the crepe business. And the most popular creperie in town, without a doubt, is Café Breton, which has been around for over a decade now. And here to tell us more about the business and how they keep diners coming back for their famous crepes is Mariela Luna, the vice president for operations of Café Breton. Hello, Mariela, and thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you for having us.
All right. I know you're going to cook for us. I'm really excited about that. But okay. First, let's talk about the business, which started back in 1998. It was sort of an accident, right?
Well, no. We were looking around. We were traveling around, and we were looking at food concepts. We were contractors, and we were building all these big restaurants. And we were wondering why there weren't smaller, cozier cafes in Manila. And we figured it was time for a nice shop, like the ones you'd find in Europe, where you could sit down and talk and have a proper meal. But we did not want a chef-based business. We wanted something that would be simple, something we could both do. So we came up with crepes because we had been seeing them everywhere.
Right.
Yeah. So
okay. And at that time, there weren't too many crepes.
You know, there
around.
Were. I remember before we opened, there were a couple that had opened a few years before, but they were way ahead of their time. So very few people remembered it. So we figured we'd give it another go.
What do you think it was about the time that you opened that, you know, crepes lasted? I mean, you know, the fad lasted, and it's sort of like now a classic. What changed over time?
Well, the time we came in, there were big restaurants, you know, like the likes of Fridays and Hard Rock and everything. And I think people were a little overwhelmed by the portions of the food. They wanted something simpler. They wanted something cozier and cheaper. So we came up with this idea where people could actually come in and talk and eat proper food, but simple. It's nothing you have to think about too much.
Right, and nothing
yeah.
too intimidating.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how did you actually learn how to make the crepes?
Okay, well, we met a guy, a French guy in Boracay, who had an 8-seater crepe hut. And we were actually asking him to open in Manila because we felt it would be a good idea. And he said he didn't want to come to Manila, but instead offered to teach us the basics. So we said, okay, fine, how much? Paid him. And, you know, we were expecting, you know, a folder with all the stuff that had the
right,
directions
with all the
for it.
Information.
Yeah. But he didn't do that. So we would go to the restaurant and then watch his girl and ask, what's this and what's that? And we just put it together. So, well, you know, like the crepes we have, the most basic ones we started with, you would find in any crepe restaurant in France, you know, the ham and cheeses and everything. So we started off with that. And as the business grew, we just added the more complicated crepes. Aside from dessert, we also specialize in the savory ones. So we just kind of worked with it.
Okay, and it sort of grew organically
yeah.
according to what you were able to learn how to do and what
right.
people wanted.
Right.
Okay, and you have two types of crepes, the regular crepes and the galettes.
The galette.
What's the difference?
Okay, the regular crepe is made from regular flour, white flour, and the galette is made from buckwheat flour. Now, we have had to tweak it a bit here in the Philippines, not to make it the pure buckwheat, because the buckwheat crepe is a little more earthy in taste. So people were saying, oh, it tastes like soil, tastes funny.
Okay.
So we've had to mix it, but with another wheat flour. Because that's traditionally buckwheat is grown in as a specialty flour in France. So we have to search for that just to make it authentic, because we
right.
want to stick to the authenticity.
So the buckwheat is like a little healthier, right?
Yes. It's actually a pure buckwheat crepe should have no gluten.
Oh, I see, I see.
So it's like flatter
right.
and yeah, more
right.
artisan.
Okay. And, you know, fast forward to today.
Mm-hmm.
It's been 13 years
yep.
since you guys opened. Tell me about how the business has been able to grow. And all your branches are company-owned,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes, they are. Well, okay, the first rule we had was that we would not take any loans to expand. So as a branch grew and moved on to another one, whatever we would earn from one branch would be forwarded to the next branch. We've always believed in starting our restaurants with as little capital as possible, making sure that every material we used was the right one that would last for a long time. Basic, didn't have to be high tech, because the crepe is a very simple thing. We ordered local materials, used local products, and we just made sure that we didn't cut corners, but that we were always consistent.
Right, and at the very beginning, and for quite some time, you were the one literally at the stove and cooking and
yes.
All of that, right? How long was that before you were actually able to train and hire enough people to take care of all the branches?
Okay, the first branch had to be us, really. Me, cooking, Tony, with the coffee, because we really couldn't afford to hire people. So it had to be us. So for the first branch, it was us day in and day out. When we had the second branch, we had to hire more people, so we had to divide our time between the first branch and the second branch. So I would do the training, and I guess for the first 3 years, that was our daily grind, you know, going to the restaurant at 3, opening at 5, closing at 4 in the morning, sleeping, waking up at noon, going to the supermarket to buy supplies, and starting all over again.
So you kind of really left behind the interior design work that you were doing and the contracting
yes.
that he was doing.
Well, now we do our design work and our own construction for the
right.
restaurant.
Yeah, that's the nice, that's
that's
the nice part about
yeah.
it, right?
Yeah.
Right? Okay, and now that you have, how many branches again?
11,
going on 12.
Hopefully the 13th by next year also.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Do you have to, you know, move around and go branch to branch every day? I mean, you know, it's a food business, so somebody's got to be looking
right.
and you know, keeping the standards up.
Well, it doesn't have to be us anymore, because now we have people whom we have trained to watch the stores, and they go around to make sure that everything is done based on our systems and standards. We have a very good group of people who do this for us. So even if we're away, it's the same thing. So you have to trust your people, and you have to trust that you've passed on your standards to them, so they can actually do the work while you're away.
Yeah, well, I've eaten in many different branches of Cafe Breton, and
you are they the same?
Yeah, they are, okay. Exactly, they yeah. are. So good job for you guys there.
Okay.
How do you plan on expanding?
Okay, well, aside from setting up more branches, we've added a few non-crepe items to the menu. Our burger, surprisingly, has been on some best burger lists.
Oh.
We have a couple of salads, a few sandwiches, but we don't really want the other food to overtake the crepe, because essentially it's still a creperie. It's just that some people say, you know, I love your crepes, I want it for dessert, mm-hmm. but can you give me something more for a meal? And well, we didn't want to compromise the crepe thing, so salads and sandwiches, I think, are okay.
Yeah, it's still good,
yeah.
light.
And we make our own bread. We make our own bread. We make it from wheat, so we try to make it as healthy as possible. Most people have been clamoring for French fries with the burgers, but we have stubbornly refused and keep the salad on the side. So maybe
right.
that's a healthier option.
Right. And I understand that the recipe for the crepe itself mm-hmm. is kind of a secret. How do you manage to keep that a secret with so many branches and so okay. many people under you?
Well, the life of the store is a crepe, the basic crepe, and it's a very simple thing. But since it is the life of the restaurant, it has to be a secret recipe, right? So somebody does, from the commissary, somebody does the dry part, somebody mixes up the wet portion. When it gets to the restaurant, somebody mixes it together, and somebody else cooks it. So there are only two people who know it from beginning to end. So that's me and Tony.
Okay. And then you hope, like, the dry part guy and the wet part guy and
never
the assembly
see each
girl
other.
Don't talk to each other.
we also have a confidentiality clause.
Right. Okay. That's good.
No, but I think our people know how important it is. Mm. We've never really had problems with that.
That's great.
Yeah.
What would you say are the best sellers?
Okay, well,
after all these years,
the Lapinai has always been the best seller.
Which is
that's
the mango and
chocolate syrup, vanilla ice cream, the Magnifique, bananas and Nutella and whipped cream, the blueberries and cream, catching up. We have a very good sausage that we do on the crepe. That's good too.
Yes,
and
I think
the chorizo.
I had that. Yes.
And the chorizo.
Those are quite good.
Yes.
Have you ever had compliments from people saying that this is exactly what I had when I went to Brittany. I mean, you know, like, how authentic are the crepes? They're good, but how close are they to what you would get in France?
Okay, well, we, on the weekends, we mostly have expats in the restaurant, and most of them are French, and they say it's very authentic. I've had a couple of guys say that I cook like their grandmother from Brittany.
That was a huge compliment.
Huge. The female ambassador to France said I cook like a French woman.
Wonderful.
I wanted to jump out of my skin and hug her. So I think a niece of ours who lives in the States but is half French says that when she wants a real crepe, she remembers us even when she's in France.
Wow.
So I'm quite happy with that.
Yeah, well, thank you for bringing this part of France to this part of the Philippines.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, what are the challenges, though, in being in a business like this? You've obviously enjoyed a lot of success, but now you have issues like the rising cost of, raw materials and stuff.
Right. Well, it's the prices that hurt, really. So in our 13 years, I think we've only raised our prices 3 or 4 times because we've really had to keep it down. So we take profit cuts instead of raising our prices. But, you know, at the end of the day, we just tell our staff, you know what, can we just make sure we don't waste things so we, you know, we don't have to raise our prices and everything. In terms of our staffing, all our employees are regulars, and I think that helps because they really take care of us. We don't have to worry about them leaving us after training and everything, although we have been successful in sending a few out of the country because of the experience they've had.
Okay.
The rentals can be quite daunting,
right,
also. Well, we just have to make more.
Yeah.
We just have to make more.
Yeah. And
basically
find good locations that are still
that's it.
Very, very reasonable.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about what Tammy is making. I think she's making the dessert crepe now, right?
Okay, I think she put in some mangoes there, some chocolate syrup, and she's making a fantastic pinay, which is mangoes, chocolate syrup, whipped cream, Nutella. That's
wonderful.
Another bestseller. We couldn't bring any ice cream, so we just did the whipped cream.
That looks pretty good to me. Now, as we said, you've got a lot of people under you, and
yes,
you've trained them. Do you still have it in you to
of course
do the magic?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
I can cook 2 crepes to 1 to this girl.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah. It's a showdown between Mariela and Tammy. All right, should we walk over there then?
Sure.
All right. That smells amazing.
Actually, I have to know how to do this because then...
Because you've got to continue training people,
yes,
with,
well,
as they come
crepe
and go.
I usually stand up with a timer and time them. Because a good crepe should be done in like 30 seconds.
30 seconds.
Yeah.
Just the batter part.
Yeah.
Right. And is there any like secret to this is the part that I find very intimidating. Because you have, you know, there's a certain time element, right? Before
yes,
it starts to cook, but you have to make it like that almost perfect circle.
Yeah, by the time you finish making your circle, it should be ready to be turned over.
Okay.
And it should be thin enough that you can see the spatula right underneath it.
Oh, okay.
And if it's cooked really well, it won't stick. If you're billig, this is what you call a billig, B-I-L-L-I-G.
Which means what?
Which is a crepe machine.
Ah,
so that's that. So it has to look like that.
Okay, and you had this specially made here in the Philippines.
Yes, we did. We start, there are quite a few good equipment makers here. So we have a couple of French ones. Not much better. So
let's go with the Pinoy then.
Yeah, you know, like if you can give more business to people in the Philippines, better.
Why not? All right. And how much do you tend to invest? Let's say per store. How
per
much
store,
do you invest on equipment?
It depends on the size of the store because like we have stores that start from 4 to 8 square meters to 150. I'm sorry. I'm operations. You would have to ask Tony about the price.
All right. We're going to call him out then.
It's like it really depends on the mall because we have to like do the deposits and things.
Yes.
So there's a lot of things. But I guess for a small restaurant, I really don't want to put my foot in my mouth here. I cook crepes. I cook.
Do you ever get sick of eating crepes?
No. I can't get sick of eating crepes because this is my life.
True. Do you do it at home?
No, you know what? Surprisingly, I do not have a machine at home. Because everything is in the restaurant.
Right.
And I figure if I had to cook, I'd cook it in the restaurant so I can check and work on it anyway. So, no. But one day I will.
I'm sure. You have to have a crepe party in your house or something, right? Inviting people over to the restaurants. Okay, so this is another lapinay, is it?
Yes. It's a mango and chocolate syrup. Well, fantastic pinay because now we have to put the Nutella.
There you go. Of course, I'm not going anywhere as we take a break because I'm looking at my very hungry cameraman and all the other guys in the studio. So I'm sorry. Some of these are mine. All right, Mariela, thank you so much for talking to us today. And of course, thank you to Tammy, who did a great demo as well. All right, we're taking a short break. Stay tuned. Shop Talk will be right back.